What's up, you guys? It's Grace Jr. and I'm back on your screen with a brand new video. And today, as you can see, I look a little funny and my hair looks a little funny because today I'm gonna be dyeing my hair. So you may ask, why am I dyeing my hair? What color am I dyeing my hair? I am just doing flat out black. I use one N and that's like one neutral. A lot of blonde people use one A because it has more of an ash, but I like the one N because it has more of the blue undertone. But I'm gonna start showing you guys what I use. I use Paul Mitchell and it's just permanent color, one N. And then with that I use 20 volume, same with Paul Mitchell. I use 20 volume developer. I have my little measuring thing for the developer, my bowl, brush, because I want to do my hair because I got a special guest coming. Well, three special guests coming next week. I think it's next week. Is it next week? Yeah, next week on the 18th. I'm really excited. You guys will all have to wait for that video, but just know I'm very excited. But I just wanted to do my hair before they came. I don't have to worry about it. I'm planning on straightening my hair for a video, but obviously I wanted to color my hair. So let me start now. I'm gonna use the whole bottle, like I always do. And then I'll explain to you guys why I dye my hair. This is 2.5 ounces, 75 millimeters. And yeah, we'll just get started. I want to talk to you guys about why it is that I dye my hair, because my hair is pretty much, I mean, I haven't done my hair in like, I want to say like almost 4 months, and obviously you can't really see too much regrowth. Honestly, my hair is pretty much like when I was in beauty school, like I tested it on what like level it would be on, and it was number 2. Number 2 is like the second darkest, 1 being legit like black. So I just decided to go with black, and the reason for doing my hair, for dyeing my hair and all that, is because when I was in beauty school, I actually dyed my hair. Well, not me, but I had one of my friends from beauty school dye my hair, and well, it didn't really, because we were in beauty school, obviously, it didn't go like I planned it to go. It was very interesting. And I pretty much wanted highlights. I'll show you guys pictures. The exact pictures that I showed her. So I wanted highlights in my hair. Kind of to just make my curls like pop out a lot more. I felt like it would look really cute. And it was super... It was like, it wasn't too much, but it wasn't like too little. It was just enough because I wanted a little change, you know? It was like back in April, I want to say. So yeah, I dyed my hair. First time ever. I had virgin hair all my life. Literally all my life. 18 years of virgin hair. Well, yeah, because it was before I turned 19. So yeah, 18 years of virgin hair. And like I said, we did it at school. One of the instructors helped my friend, and I felt good about it. We had talked about it for a long time. I told her, like, hey, we're not doing it until I know for a fact that you, like, are comfortable doing it, because I do have curly hair, and so it was different. She learned how to do a lot of stuff with my hair because I have curly hair, so in a way, I was kind of like her guinea pig, and yeah. So I just put 3 ounces on here. Well, I put 2.5, almost 3, just because that's how many it is, and it's 1-to-1 ratio. So I'm just gonna pour that in there. So then we did my hair, obviously. Everything was good. The process was a few hours. The teacher that was there pretty much told her to do it a certain way, and she saw me on her chair, she was kind of freaking out. I could tell. You could just feel the vibes. And so because of that, I was like, am I sure about this? Like, do I really want to do this? Da, 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 da. did it anyways though. I don't wanna. So this is what the color. It's so weird how it doesn't like match the color. But I'm just mixing it right now. Technically you shouldn't mix your color with the brush that you're using, but I don't have a whisk for hair color. Anyways, I got home and when I was like driving home, I really liked the way it looked. It was like a really nice golden color. I wish I saw pictures, you guys, but I seriously don't have any pictures because I deleted all of them. And so once I got home, I showed my mom and she was like, oh wow. And let me tell you guys, I was like thinking about doing my hair for the longest time, like literally like months and months, almost like a whole year. Like I was thinking about it for such a long time. She was blow drying it, but she wasn't able to finish. So, and it was like still kind of puffy. Like my hair was super puffy and frizzy because of the fact that she didn't finish. It was already time for us to go home, and well, because I'm a student, they just sent me out the door pretty much with my hair not even finished blow dried. So I had put up my hair for that reason, got home, took my hair down, had my mom take a picture, and I noticed that when I saw the picture, it was very stripy. Like, you guys, when I tell you it was stripy, like, it was very stripy. It just looked like tire stripes. I did not like it. And, like, we had some drama, like, with me and my friend because of that fact. But I wasn't, like, rude about it or anything. I was just, like, I just said it how it was. Like, I didn't like it. And, I mean, you're in beauty school. I didn't expect it to be perfect, you know? But, like, I didn't blame it all on her. I blamed it mostly on the instructor because she did it the way the instructor told her to do it. Because that's how you're supposed to do it with curly hair. But whatever. I just start in the center, and I'm gonna do like all four quadrants all the way down. It's kind of hard doing it yourself just because you can't really see the back, but I've done it before, so it's not too bad. But like I was saying, a few months pass and haven't done anything, haven't bothered getting it fixed just because, one, I didn't have any money. Two, I just didn't, I don't know. I just had, for like pretty much a month straight, I literally like had my hair up every single day for like, literally like every single day for months. And my other beauty school friend, she's actually was really good, and like everyone went to her, like everyone loved her. She did everyone's hair and it was so good, and we were like, hey, how about we do like a black blue and we put it on like the highlights, because then obviously it would pop. And I'm like, oh my god, that'd be so cool, because I've always wanted to do like a black blue, you know. I feel like that's just like such a cool color, and I don't know, I just thought it would look good. So without filling my hair, so this is really hard to explain for people that don't understand, but I'll try to keep it short. Pretty much filling your hair is when you have blonde hair and you want to go back like to dark hair. You don't just put the color on there just because it's going to look muddy and like it just will not look like good at all. For that to not happen, what people do is they fill their hair. So I did that with my cousin, actually, because she went from a blonde to a brunette. Anyways, we didn't do that. We actually just put the color, like, straight on there. And I think that's kind of where we went a little bit wrong, in a sense. Just because, okay, so my hair, after I had done my hair, once it washed out, like, the toner washed out, the undertone of my hair was a like yellow. It was like a golden color, but it was not cute. Like it faded to a really ugly gold, you know. And because of that, I was like, ew, like it's so ugly, like I need to get this off. Impatient about it, and I just said, let's just do it, put it right on top. So because of the fact that my hair was yellow, and then I added that the blue, Well, it was like a black blue, but it was obviously mostly blue because I mixed those two colors. Once the color faded, you guys, my hair, you can kind of see the brown right here, actually. My hand's clean, yeah. Let me show you. Oh, yeah, you can for sure see that. That is, like, previously lightened blonde hair. But now you guys get, like, an idea of, like, why I'm doing it. So once it faded, it turned into a really ugly, pretty much green. Just because, again, I don't know why I didn't think about this when we were doing it. But obviously, I had yellow hair, and then we put blue on it. Obviously, that's gonna freaking turn it green. But again, we didn't think about that because we didn't fill my hair. If we would have filled my hair, it would have been fine. Because it wouldn't fade to that, like, really ugly color. So I was just like, are you kidding me, dude? Like, this is so ugly. What the hell am I gonna do? I was just freaking out. So then I let that sit in my hair for another few months. And it was, like, summertime. And at this point, I was like, dude, like, this is so ugly. Like, I need to get this crap together because this is so ugly. Like, what am I doing with my life? You know? So, fast forward a few months later into, like, summer, I'm pretty sure. At this point, I was still over my hair. So I was like, whatever. I am just going to put black all over it. And so I went to the store myself. And I just got regular 1N. And that's it. I then started to pretty much dye my whole head black. I've only done it, this is the third time I've dyed my hair. Like I said, I don't do it very often because I'm just doing it when the grays, or not the grays, when the browns start coming out in my hair. And it's not like too noticeable, so it's not horrible, you know. But yeah, like I said, I'm going to finish this. And once I'm done with everything, I will come back and talk to you guys and update you on what I will be doing next. Alright guys, so I just finished my hair. I'm just kind of making sure I'm brushing it all the way. So I'm going to finish cleaning this up, and at 4:04 I need to take this off. And once it's 4:04, I'll pick up the vlog again. For the time being, I'm just gonna chill, make sure I'm not touching anything because my hair dyed. I got about 38 minutes, so I got some time on me, but I'm gonna clean the stuff. I'll pick up the video when I'm done. Alright guys, so I just got out of the shower. It was a struggle. It's like you guys know, I have white curtains. And I was like going like this, and it was going all over the place. I was freaking out. So I was like, nope, I have to freaking turn this off and like actually be careful. I just cleaned the bathroom because obviously there's like some stains. I just put the shirt on too because I don't care if the shirt gets full of dye. But I'm just going to diffuse my hair really fast because I actually have to go to work in 30 minutes. So I'm going to do that. Alright guys, so last thing that I do is I put olive oil leave-in conditioner, which is this one, and then I use the Morocco, or Argan Oil of Morocco. I mix these two and then I just put them into my hair, and this is what my hair is looking like. I'm wearing my work clothes because I have to head to work. My hair is pretty much mostly dry, so I'm glad about that. I'm gonna use one of these rubber bands. These are really good for people that have their hair straightened and they don't want to leave the little bumps, or if you have curly hair and you don't want it to be like really tight. But this is gonna be the end of this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to like and subscribe, turn on your post notifications to get notified every single time I upload a new Vlogmas. And with that being said, I will see you guys all tomorrow. Peace.